We interrupt our regularly scheduled musical programming with this special bulletin. I am your announcer, Michael Nouri. This just in. The notorious Impro Theatre has been seen in the vicinity of the Lincoln Theatre in Yountville. They are armed and spontaneous. Repeat, armed and spontaneous. This gang of thespians will make up stories entirely based on audience suggestion with no pre-planned characters and no preset plot structure. They will stop at nothing to improvise the entire show. And they may be coming to you for suggestions on which to base that show. I have just learned that the music for the show will also be improvised. This is a dire situation, ladies and gentlemen. Please don't panic. This show will be performed only once, and you are the only audience who will see whatever it is it turns out to be. There will be no intermission. But I must warn you, if you encounter any of the actors in the lobby, please remember this. They prefer a crisp Sauvignon Blanc to an oaky Chardonnay. Above all, approach them with caution. They are maniacs. Yes, maniacs on the floor, and they're improvising like they've never done before. Wait. I have an update. Yes. They are actually in the theater. Now, and they are about to begin the show. Repeat. Ah, there will even be simulated gunshots in the show. Yes, they are about to begin the show. Ladies and gentlemen, please turn off any and all electronic devices. Any unexpected noises may be mistaken for sniper fire and will be dealt with accordingly. That is all.
Good evening. Welcome to Pinot Noir Unscripted, a completely improvised film noir play. We only just got on the set about an hour ago, so you're going to see a film noir play on the Angel Heart set. We're being very sustainable and green with our theater. So, to get things started, we need a suggestion from you of something your family may have owned in the 40s or 50s to create our completely improvised play.
A radio,
a black and white television. A Chevy Impala.
A washboard.
And a washboard. What was that last one?
A dial telephone.
I think we're going to take, ooh, Tommy gun. We're going to take washboard, and we may work in all the other ones as well. But thank you very much. And now, Pinot Noir, washboard.
I guess I'm nostalgic. Is that the word? Nostalgic? Thinking about, I don't know, my youth. Oh. You know, a man gets on in years, he starts to look behind. A lot of reasons a man looks behind.
Some place to look behind at. Razor Strop Alley. That's what you called it when you were telling me about it.
Yeah.
Said all the boys who looked behind were looking at a behind that had been hit with a razor strop. That's what they called it, Razor Strop Alley.
That's right, Denny. Razor Strop Alley. My dad taught me, and he taught me good. He taught all the kids real good. We all learned to watch your back, side.
Huh. Hey, is that the building where your ma used to take in the washing?
Yeah, that's right. I used to watch her for hours on end, hunched over that galvy tub. hands would be rough and withered, red, using that harsh lye soap, taking in other people's wash, while my old man drank everything that she made. He ruined her. He ruined her, Denny. The most decent woman that ever breathed air. She died way too soon, too sad. Life wore her out, and he pushed her to the end. I hate him, Denny.
Is that why we're back here? You're hoping you might find your old man here?
There's always a chance. Sometimes the only way you can move forward in life is to look behind you, see where you've been, get back to where you were, so you can get on with going where you're going. Without forgetting where you were. And yet at the same time, I'm lost now, Denny.
No, I get you.
Doesn't it make you happy?
What, sitting in the car?
Huh?
Sitting in the car?
No, not sitting in the car.
What makes you happy then?
This town.
Yeah. It's a nice town, isn't it?
Yeah, it's beautiful. You know, I grew up here.
Oh, really?
Yeah, did I tell you that?
Yeah.
I always wanted to be on the force.
Oh. Mm-hmm. That explains your strength.
My strength?
Yeah, growing up in Hercules.
It's the first time I've heard that one.
It's a joke we tell in Pinole.
That town sounds made up.
Yeah, it's a real town.
Oh, yeah? It's a real town?
Yeah, Pinhole, Pinole.
Ah, yeah, it's probably the size of one.
Yeah, yeah. And then there's Pittsburgh, which people think is on the other coast, but it's here.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. It's right here. So you joined the force for what reason?
More of the same, really. After the war, I just took what I knew and I kept it going.
Yeah, knock on wood.
Yeah. Leave that alone, huh?
What do you got?
I call that my Captain Ahab.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Did you ever read Moby Dick?
No.
He lost his leg.
Moby Dick?
Captain, no, not Moby Dick. Moby Dick was a whale.
I was going to say, why do a whale lose a dick? I mean, a leg. Don't tell the captain I said that. Yeah. It'd be a shame for anybody to lose a leg.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Thankfully, there's a dip of crime in this town where a cop like me with a wooden leg can actually get a pay.
Yeah, well.
Jaywalkers and kids leaving their bubble gum on the sidewalk. It's just about the worst of it.
Yeah, it's a 50-cent fine.
50 cents?
50 cents.
You know what, you can buy a lot with 50 cents.
Yeah, more gum.
But it does make you long for the days of action, doesn't it?
Yeah.
You had purpose over there.
Yeah.
I was a staff sergeant.
Were you?
In charge of the coming and going.
Did you go anywhere?
No, supplies.
Oh, I
supply
see.
Staff sergeant.
Oh, okay. So you were in charge of coming and going, but you stayed set.
You know, we've been partners for 2 years. This is the most conversation we've ever had.
Well, we ran out of donuts.
Go ahead, car 14. Say that again.
Louis De Palma Sr.
Louis De Palma Sr. Edith, you really got to do something about that sinus problem. Yeah. A copy, we're on our way. Louis De Palma Sr., you know who he is, don't you?
I knew who he was.
Yeah? How do you know who he was?
Huh?
I said, how do you know who he was?
The richest man in town, you know?
Yeah?
Not know who he is.
Well, his son, you know, sends a big wheel in the mob.
That's unsubstantiated.
That's true. Well, let's go substantiate it.
Pardon me, miss. I didn't mean to scare you. My partner's parking the car.
That's fine. That's fine. The body's upstairs.
Yes.
Do you have a light? I've been just holding this cigarette and puffing on it, and I realize it's not even lit.
Here. Relax. Is that better?
It's as good as it's gonna get. I've only known him for about 6 months.
De Palma?
Louis, senior, that is.
Hey, look, do you want to sit down?
Sure.
Here, I'll open a window. Here, have a seat, bud, huh? Catch a breeze, will you?
I found parking. Body upstairs?
Body's upstairs.
Right. Here, have a seat, huh?
I just came home. I'm a singer over at the coconut room.
Oh, yeah, I knew I recognized you from somewhere. That's a great place.
Thank you.
Oh, here. Don't cry, huh?
Oh.
Don't cry, will you?
Oh, let me not burn you.
Oh, that's all right. This jacket's got a lot of holes.
No. You're awfully swell. Awfully swell for a copper.
You know, we don't take kindly necessarily to be referred to as coppers.
Oh, sorry. I've been here with Louis for so long, I don't even know what's up and what's down and what's right and what's left and what's inside and what's out.
Again, do you want to have a seat and calm down a little bit?
I should probably get an ashtray, huh?
That's all right.
Sure. He's dead. What's the floor?
Yeah,
anyway?
Here's one. Yeah, I'll put it right here on the windowsill.
Oh, thanks.
It was when he died.
Well, yes, because he wouldn't move after he died.
Very good, sir.
What are you?
I'm the valet, sir.
The valet?
Yes. The valet, sir.
What's a valet?
It's like a butler, only it sounds better.
See. What's that he's got in his hands? Are those grapes?
Yes. Chardonnay grapes.
What was he doing with grapes?
Squeezing them.
That's a really tedious way to make wine.
He was a perfectionist. He squoze every grape by hand that went in every bottle of his vintages.
Must be pretty expensive.
Very. He only made one bottle.
I'm telling you, I don't know anything about the washboard that's next to his body. He always kept that thing around in the bedroom, and I was like, what's with the washboard, Louis? And he would never tell me. I think he felt bad about something to do with that washboard.
But he always kept it with him?
Well, always in the room there.
Mr. Palma, I finished cleaning. Can I go?
Thank you, Carlotta.
Can I go?
Are you sure you cleaned everything?
I finished cleaning.
Thank you, Carlotta.
Who's this?
This is one of the detectives.
Detective Smith.
Detective Carlotta. Smith.
Carlotta Ruiz.
Carlotta's nice to meet you. With Louis Sr. a long time.
I've been working for him for almost all of his adulthood.
She said all of his adulthood.
Do you normally clean the house wearing that?
That's right. I like to clean the house in a bikini. What do you care? I get very hot when I clean.
Fair enough.
Then I jump in the water. Then I feel better. Don't worry about it. Can I go, Mrs. De Palma?
I said yes already.
I need my man.
And it's Miss De Palma.
I'll just continue cleaning everything in this room. It's my job. I hope that doesn't make it difficult for you to do any of your police
work. No, you don't need to clean anything else. You see, this is a crime scene. You can't clean anything.
Oh, I've already vacuumed and dusted.
You know, that makes you a suspect.
Very good, sir.
Why is that very good?
Because I always say very good when I don't know what else to say, sir.
I see.
I need my money, Miss De Palma. My man.
Really, Carlotta, after there's been a murder?
I need to live. I need to buy food and things just like any person.
Did you say you need to live or you need to leave? Your accent gets thicker by the day, Carlotta.
I need to live and I need to leave.
Then let me help you live and leave. Oh. Just get my purse. Hello.
Hello. Did you say hello?
I said hello.
Careful, you don't choke when you greet somebody.
There you are, Carlotta.
Well, he's dead as a doornail.
Obviously, I don't know if we'll need you next week.
You better need me next week. Nice to meet you, gentlemen.
She said nice to meet you,
gentlemen. I heard what she said. That translates into any language.
Perhaps we should leave our cards.
Wait a minute, I'm still watching her leave. Wow. It's a whole lot of heat.
Yeah.
It's like she's a furnace on two pins.
Like I said, I'd only been here about 6 months, so I should be free to leave.
Why don't you have a seat?
I've been trying to get her to sit down all
day.
Sit
down.
It's just that I'm very upset. I've never seen a murder real close up at all.
Well, were you home? Did you hear anything? These are questions we normally ask.
Well, not normally, because nothing like this has really ever happened in my time on the force.
We're both being abnormal with you.
It's all right. It's been a real abnormal kind of a humdinger day.
Has it?
Well, I came home real early from the coconut room.
She works at the coconut room.
Oh, yeah. She's a singer.
Yes.
Yeah. What's your name?
My name.
Yes.
My name's Evelyn.
Evelyn?
Yes.
Evelyn Steamer?
That's my stage name, and that might as well be the name you call me.
Well, I'd rather call you your real name for police purposes.
Then call me Evelyn Steamer.
Your real name is Steamer?
Sure.
Here's our card. We may have some questions. Come on.
I may have answers.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Coming up next, Evelyn Steamer!
Talks about fire and earthquakes.
Yeah. But it makes sense if you keep listening.
Right. Earthquakes is such a rhymeable word.
Yeah, but she pulls it off.
Yeah.
I got a man sure that man is mine.
Say, Evelyn, there's some guy over there wants to buy you a drink. He said he wanted to buy you a couple. I said, she's performing tonight. Only get her one.
Trixie, what's he look like?
It's that guy.
That guy. Tell him I'll be right over.
All right.
How's my face?
You look great, Evelyn. You always do.
Thanks, Trix.
This place is so busy, I got an empty chair. I'll keep this open for her. I'll flag her down.
All right. There's no other chairs. It's so crowded. I'm sorry, ma'am, for tipping ash into your drink.
I like the way you sing.
Oh, I like the way you order me to come over here.
Well, it wasn't an order, it was a strenuous request.
Oh. Did you like the song?
Very much.
Did you like the clever way I rhymed earthquake with shake?
I did, very, very much.
A lot of people don't think that can be done, but I did it.
I knew you could do it. The first time I set eyes on you, I knew you could do just about anything. You started up a heart that I thought was dead a long time ago.
Really?
I'm gonna cut straight to the chase.
I like that. I don't want to play tag.
I was never very good at tag or hide and seek.
Me neither. I never liked to hide.
I'd always hide and no one would come to look for me.
I'm more of a seeker myself.
Really? Well, you might have found something right here, sister.
Say, what's your name?
My name's not important.
Really?
Well, let's say my name is a little too important. I'm Louis de Palma. Junior.
Look, I don't...
Hey, look. I like you. I like you a lot. Now, what you and my old man had... That's probably history now, I'm guessing.
Yeah, it'd be real creepy if it wasn't. Can I be honest with you?
I wish you would.
I don't know what kind of relationship you had with your old man, but he wasn't the nicest guy.
Then you knew him pretty well.
And I was sort of looking for a way out, but I didn't make the way out that it looked like I did, if you know what I'm saying.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're saying.
Sorry if that hurts your feelings. I don't know if you and your old man were close.
I don't have any feelings left to be hurt. All my feelings got all felt out.
Wow. That's a bad thing to happen to your feelings. Look, if you're here for money or anything like that, I'm sure he left it all to you.
Did you think that old codger left anything to me?
I know he left you some stuff.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure he left me some stuff.
I know he left you a washboard for some weird reason. He said to me, if anything ever happens to me, I got a box of stuff. There's a letter that'll tell you where to get it.
Miss Steeman, 5 minutes.
Thanks, Paco.
You're welcome.
Listen, I know it's kind of strange rattling around in that big old house all by yourself.
I guess you'd like me to move on out, huh? Really got any other place to go, but I can make myself scarce.
I can find you a place to go.
Something's happening.
What's the matter? Can't you knock on a door?
My knock doesn't work.
Try again.
All right, I'll try it one more time.
Oh, Paco, I said just a minute.
Are you in trouble, miss?
Oh.
Oh, Junior.
Louis.
Oh, we haven't seen you in these parts in a long time.
Yeah, Just came to visit, old time's sake.
Yeah, the prodigal son.
Oh, put it there. It's great to see you. It's been a long time, yeah, since before.
Yeah, we heard you moved out of town.
Yeah, I moved out of town. I just came back. I was feeling, nostalgic.
Yeah.
Hey, so sorry about your father, but...
Oh, yeah, I just heard. Hey, you know, the truth is we were never really that close.
Yeah, we heard you moved, like you were in San Francisco, Sonoma, Napa, Daly City.
I travel a lot. Business, you know.
Listen, gentlemen, I'm just gonna go behind the screen and start changing
Go right ahead, Bob.
Hey, I'm a detective now.
Good for you.
Thanks.
That's nice.
Yeah. I'm a detective, junior grade.
Really?
Hey, you gotta come over for some hot dogs.
I would love that.
Just
ever
like,
so much.
Just like I was gonna say, just like old times.
Never mind. I interrupted too much, I'm sorry.
That's all right. Sorry to barge in like that, but didn't know she was with a friend.
Yeah, well, we're new friends.
That's great.
Hey,
really
real
great.
Sorry to hear about your father's passing.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
Sure.
Thanks a lot.
Sure.
Listen, how much longer are you gents gonna be? I gotta go out for my next number.
Oh, we were gonna escort you out for next number.
Detectives, huh?
Yeah.
Wow, congratulations.
Thanks.
You working on anything big?
Well, we're working on your father's murder.
I got a jigsaw puzzle. I'm almost done. I got about 500 pieces in it.
The only clues we have are a washboard, a black and white television, and a Chevy Impala.
Well, I gotta go.
Excuse me.
And now, everybody's favorite, the woman who can really fog up your windows, Evelyn Steamer.
In the maple forest.
I tell you to stay someplace, I expect you to stay there. I'll be wandering around.
I'm sorry, I got so interested in the trees. You know, I'm collecting pictures of woodpeckers.
Yeah. You collecting pictures of woodpeckers at night? What's the matter with you?
Some of them are nocturnal.
Look, Danny, we may have a little bit of a situation.
Oh, like what kind of situation, Louis?
There's a couple of detectives snooping around.
Okay.
But they know me. We go back a ways. When I lived here before, we used to pal around together.
So you mean we should turn into woodpeckers? Go knock, 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 knock.
Calm down, Danny. I don't like it when you get excited like that.
Sure thing.
It unnerves me. I just want you to discourage them.
Uh-huh. Discourage them. Like an ostrich. Stick their heads in the sand, huh, boss? All the way down.
Yeah, like an ostrich.
What's the matter? You seem troubled. This used to be the fun part for you.
It's different when it's family. Even if it's someone you hate, it's different. Put a lot of people down.
Sure.
I'll probably put a lot more down before my career is over.
Sure.
But this one's different.
Sure.
This one counts. This one I take with me. This is like a tattoo on my soul. I can't wash this off. The rest I can forget about. It was business. It was money. This is different.
It's like that stain on the washboard right in the middle. That might have come up from blood, and it's stuck there, and it won't get off. No matter how many times you try to rub that bloody stain off the middle of the washboard, it won't come off, even if you use lye soap and a brush, right?
Yeah. Even if you use lye soap and a brush, some stains just don't come out.
The last name. Carlotta. Carlotta. Can you read that?
Well, sure. It's Violet.
Carlotta Violet? That doesn't make sense.
That's what it says. Oh. You asked me to say it, and I told you what it was.
Well, it doesn't look like Violet to me.
Well, look at it in the light and take a closer look.
I can hear you outside.
Yeah, we're outside your house.
My last name is Ruiz.
Ruiz.
Yeah, package for Carlotta Ruiz.
Oh, yeah, I'll take that for her.
Thank you.
Do you want me to come down the stairs?
Yeah. Who knew that you'd live out in the middle of the woods like this? It's kind of a creepy place. You're like Rapunzel.
Don't worry about it. I'm coming down the stairs.
I think she said don't worry about it. She's coming down the stairs.
All right.
Look at that. There's a creek running by our house. We could come trout fishing here.
Huh. It's a nice heavy little package. Wonder what it is.
You talking about the box or her?
Yeah, maybe both. She's got a lot of mystery in her, too.
Look at that.
Hello?
Hello.
We just had a couple of questions since you worked for the deceased.
Come in, ask me anything. I'm an open book.
I left my notebook in the car. I'll in a second.
All right, well, you want to give her a package?
Oh, sure.
Someone brought a package for me?
Yes.
For Carlotta Ruiz?
Yes.
Not Carlotta Violet?
No, that was just bad handwriting. Yeah, why don't you go get your notebook? Have you always lived by this creek, Miss Ruiz?
Don't worry about it. Do you want to come in or not?
Oh, sure, sure. It's
come just, through this door.
It's just that, you know, a lot of water runs down this creek. I know that's obvious, but I like to say obvious things sometimes.
I have delicious food inside.
Delicious food?
Do you want some of it?
What did you say?
Do you want some of it?
Yes.
Come in.
I'm worried you're going to break your own jaw. All right. Oh, what a lovely place you have.
Thank you. Let me bring out some chairs. I don't like any furniture when I'm here by myself.
I see.
If someone comes in, then I bring the chairs out.
It's a very, very strange way of hosting people. Oh, so you've got quite a nice wine collection.
That's right. I only like the red kind.
Yes, red, like the color of blood.
That's right. Red like the color of blood.
Just one chair? Aren't you going to sit?
I'm going to get the other one.
All right. Now just move it into the light so we can see the moon. We just had a couple of questions about your relationship with the deceased.
Said, ask me anything. I'm an open book.
All right.
I'll get it.
I'm worried. You have a package and a chair.
I'm very strong.
I noticed that. Oh, my God. That chair is made out of solid oak and must weigh 75 pounds.
Try 82.
Well, Miss Ruiz, were you home at the time of the murder?
Yes.
So you heard a struggle, a cry? What did you hear?
I heard music, and then I heard a thud.
What kind of music? And was the thud part of the music?
The thud was not part of the music. It was the music of the lady of the house, Evelyn. One of her records was playing.
I see.
And then nothing. A thud.
And she was upstairs at the time with the deceased, or the predeceased at this point.
I think so. Only the body was there when I went into the room. Maybe she was in there when the music played. Sometimes she liked to dance for him while her own record played.
That's very self-indulgent.
It's disgusting. I tried to tell her, it's disgusting to listen to your own record while you dance for someone.
You seem to have a very strong opinion about it.
I just think if you're going to dance for someone, put on someone else's record.
What if I put on this record?
See, this is fine. This is not my music.
It depends on your taste. All right. Well, that was... Must have dropped the needle on the record. Not many people have 78s anymore.
That's right. I like old-fashioned things.
Yes. Well, I think I've gotten all the information I need at this point.
So you just wanted to know what I heard? The music and the thud? No more questions.
What was your relationship with him?
I told you, I had been working for him all of his adulthood.
All of his adulthood?
That's right.
You're very young to be working for him. Oh, a man was 66 years old.
I don't consider...
Are you laughing at me, Miss Carlotta?
No, you listen to me. Look at me. I don't consider a man.
Oh, my God, you're so strong.
I don't consider a man until he is 50.
I see.
So I've been working for him since he was 50.
So 14 years.
That's right.
All right. Well, I think that's all the questions. I don't want to lose another bicuspid.
Don't you want to know anything else?
Yes, please, tell me. The moon is setting.
Don't you want to know the mood?
Yes.
The mood of Miss De Palma.
Yes.
The way she was very quiet that day.
Yes, tell me.
The way she made three pies.
Three pies?
That's right.
What does baking have to do with a man's death?
She never bakes! I asked her, I say, how come you're baking? Why don't you want me to make the food for the day? She said, I need to get my mind off of something. I need to bake these pies to make my mind go silent.
And what did you think she was trying to get her mind off of?
No telling with her.
Well, tell me. Guess.
I think she had to get her mind off of her troubles.
You think she killed him?
I'm not saying that.
You're implying that.
She might have. She was very angry at him.
I think that's all the questions I have now.
He had slapped her in the neck.
Slapped her in the neck?
He was mad at her.
But he didn't want to hurt her face.
That's right.
So he slapped her in the neck.
Because he loved her face. So he slapped her in the neck.
Mm. I've heard about these things.
You've heard about these neck slappings?
Neck slapping.
Anyway, that morning he had slapped her in the neck. And then she got very quiet and started baking three pies. One had lemon, one had cherry, one had meat.
A meat pie?
A meat pie. Disgusting! Then she put on her own music and danced to her own music.
All right, I'll be getting back in touch with you.
You didn't need any of the delicious food I have in my house.
No, I don't have time. Here's my card. If you think of anything else, please call me on a dial phone.
It smells like cologne.
All right, I'll just put these chairs back for you.
Don't put them back!
All right, I'll just
Let
leave them
Let me get that for you.
Will you open the door?
Call you sunshine. Because when I'm gonna open you up, I'm gonna let a lot more sunshine in.
All right. Where is this gonna happen? Some dark alley? Some back road?
No, Glen Ellen.
Glen Ellen?
Yeah. The Valley of the Moon, sunshine. The Valley of the Moon!
I should probably turn here.
What did you tell him?
I told him I heard music and then I thought I said she was not in the right mind.
That's good. Did you tell him about the pies?
I told him about the three pies, and I told him about the neck slap.
The neck slap, yeah. I thought you said the next slice, and I got pie, and it got confusing.
Did I do good, Louis?
No, you did great.
Did I say everything you wanted me to?
You did everything beautiful, baby.
Good.
You know, Carlotta, we kind of grew up together.
That's right.
And I know that you've taken a lot of abuse. And I ain't a good guy. I ain't gonna lie to you.
I don't care.
And I came by it honest. I came by my dishonest life in an honest way. If that makes any sense at all. I know it doesn't even make sense to me.
It does to me, Louis. It makes sense to me.
Okay, doll. Look, all we gotta do is see this thing through all the way to the end. And that broad is gonna take the fall. And sad, but it's necessary.
Yes.
And then you and I can have a life together.
Yes.
And we'll turn this house into, well, that house into something, I don't know, decent.
Yeah, something decent.
Illegal, but decent.
Something bad but decent.
Yeah, bad but good. Kind of like us, huh?
Bad but good, just like us, Louis.
Yeah,
take a brief intermission. Welcome back to the second half of Washboard. For your education and ours as well, we're going to tell you who we think we are playing at this point in our improvised play.
Detective Smith. I am playing Detective Smith.
I'm playing Carlotta Ruiz and Trixie from the Coconut Room.
I am playing the junior detective, as yet unnamed.
I'm playing Louis De Palma Jr.
Evelyn Steamer. Stage name. I think I also go by Evelyn De Palma, right?
Yeah.
Yes, okay.
I'm Denny Paco, the MC at the Coconut Room, Club, Grove.
Coconut Room.
Coconut Room, and an unnamed valet.
Valet.
A valet. So, which of these characters would you like to see start the second half? Carlotta. One more character to be with Carlotta. And the valet. Okay, Carlotta and the valet. All right, here we go. The second half of Pinot Noir Unscripted Washboard.
You're enjoying the outside of my house? You like looking at the beautiful water?
Yes. I love to come and stand on the edge of pools. It makes me feel as if I could swim, but don't have to.
Can you swim, Charles? Can you swim in the water?
You know I can. You saw me swim the length of Mr. De Palma's pool 5 times that night.
Yes. What were you doing?
Exercising. Exercising my loyalty to an employer who had always done right by me.
Have you talked to those men? The policemen? Why are you looking down?
Why are you carrying a gun?
Because... you're not gonna do anything wrong, you understand me, Charles? Get over there, put your feet in the water.
I made a deal with you, Carlotta.
Put your feet in that water!
When Mr. De Palma died, I swam back and forth in that pool, and I stuck all of the evidence in the vents on the side.
Good. It's all still there in the vents of the pool?
Yes.
All of it?
Almost all of it.
What do you mean, almost?
I mean, there's a letter, Carlotta.
Don't make me cock this gun. What sort of letter?
A letter addressed to the police.
Okay, I'm cocking it.
A letter that says that if I die, they should open the letter.
They're not gonna know where to find it. Where is the letter?
I mailed it to the police station with special instructions on the envelope that said, if I die, you know where to find it.
Stop swimming! Stop swimming right now!
If I stop swimming...
where are you? Come up for air! What's wrong with this guy? Did I get you?
I couldn't tell. I couldn't hear if it went off. Oh! It just went off. It ricocheted off the side of the pool and shot me.
That's a river. This river has very hard sides.
Yes. That's why they call it the Russian River. Because of the Cold War and the hard
I forgot to ask you when you sent that letter to the police station!
Carlotta! Carlotta!
We don't have to worry about Charles anymore.
Sweetheart, what did you do?
The river is so slow now.
I don't know why they call it a Russian river. It seems to be taking its time. Come on. Come on. We gotta get rid of this gun.
I did it for you.
What are you doing? What are you doing? I'm sorry.
You slapped my face.
I'm sorry.
You didn't even bother to slap my neck.
I'm sorry. Come on, I'm sorry. Come on, I'm sorry.
Follow the tire tracks all the way to Glen Ellen. Morton's Warm Springs. It's like an abandoned resort. Detective? Detective Smith? Looks like there was a struggle here. And then it stopped. And then there was some more struggling. And then it stopped again. I don't understand that part. And then struggling. Looks like somebody was making s'mores. Strange thing to do in the middle of a fight. Guess you gotta eat.
It says here in my Audubon book, this is the natural habitat of the red-headed woodpecker.
Tat, 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 tat.
You think they'll answer the call when they hear it? You think they'll flock down from the trees and welcome me into their nest when they hear that little tat, 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 tat?
Maybe they will, because they recognize their own. You know, you're a lot like a woodpecker.
How so?
A small little pecker.
What are you saying?
Hey, easy, easy.
Don't insult the manhood of a man with a gun, because he's got it right here, and it can talk back.
Well, then I won't expand on that idea. It's not in my best interest,
is it? Keep moving, keep moving. You can talk while you move. No law against that, is there, lawman? You ought to know. You know all the laws.
I do. For example, murder.
Yeah. Murder.
That's against the law. Well, the moon came out from behind the clouds.
All right. Here.
What is this? If you're gonna shoot me, shoot me.
Well, I don't want to go through the trouble of digging your grave, do I?
Ah, that shovel's for me.
That's right. The shovel. And the washboard.
The washboard?
Yeah, washboard. Sometimes you can move more dirt with a washboard than you can with a shovel if it's a big enough washboard.
That doesn't make any sense.
You've never used a washboard before, have you?
No, maybe I haven't. So what if I send my clothes out?
All right, start digging.
Ah, there's a glimpse up on that ridge. Looks like a washboard. I'd recognize that glint anywhere. Detective Smith! Detective Smith!
Hey, what are you doing? I said dig!
Just wanting to examine this washboard in the moonlight. It's an antique, you know.
Is it?
Yes, it's from the late 19th century.
Oh, really?
Sure.
I didn't know that.
I mean 18th century. Did I say 19th?
18th century? No
sure.
Fooling. Let me get a closer look.
Gunshots! I recognize the glint of gunshots anyway.
Now, you don't have to say anything if you don't want to, but I'm taking you downtown.
I'm almost to the top of the hill, Detective! You'll have to catch me first!
He's on the move!
Up in the trees, but
that was supposed to be a warning shot.
I think you winged him.
Stay in the trees, you little woodpecker. He's going from tree to tree on his way down this cliff.
He keeps bouncing. Look at him bounce. My God, he must be expending so much energy bouncing off all those trees.
What are the odds of a man surviving a fall like that?
I don't know. But we better go down and find out.
I'm so glad we installed this dial phone.
Crazy kids. Oh.
I don't understand.
I think you understand just fine. You hang up the phone or I shoot you in the head. I think you picked that up real quick.
My God, you are just like your father.
Don't you say that. Don't you ever say that to me.
Oh, you backslapped me. Just like him. Because he didn't want to mess up my face either. You're horrible. He always hoped that you would make something of yourself.
I did. I did make something of myself.
Yeah,
with no face to him.
You made yourself just into him. You're exactly like him. What are you doing here? You setting me up to take the fall for this? Because you know I had nothing to do with it.
Yeah, you had nothing to do with it. Yeah, you had nothing to do with it. But you didn't have any problem sidling up next to him, huh? And siphoning off all that family cash, huh? You didn't care nothing about that. You didn't love him. You didn't... You're just a user like him. You're just like him. You're more like him than I am.
I don't think me using him for some money and to back up my singing career is the same thing as murder.
Maybe not. But somebody's got to pay for it. It's not going to be me. Oh, maybe I should answer this. Hello?
Is Evelyn there? This is Detective Jones.
She just stepped out.
Oh, well, I'm calling from a payphone at Napa State Hospital.
Whoever it is, I need help!
That was not a good idea! You're messing everything up, Evelyn.
I promise I won't mess anything up, I promise.
I can't let you.
Listen, Paco's gonna be here any minute to pick me up for my set tonight.
All right. Okay, well, we can't have anything going wrong or unusual. Really, the only reason I came by is I wanted to ask you a question. Has Carlotta been here?
Carlotta?
Yeah, Carlotta.
No.
You haven't seen her at all?
Oh my God, is she in on this with you?
Look. All she ever did was take care of him. All she ever did was take care of him.
I'm the one who took care of him.
You didn't do nothing. Don't make me neck slap you again. I might miss. Come on, why don't you get ready for your next show? We're gonna go together. I'll give you a ride. Come on, let's go. Let's go!
Then she screamed. I don't know who answered the phone, but she screamed.
Well, she's got to be tied up in this in some way.
Of course she is. It's raining pretty hard. Either that or a fountain broke.
What happened to this town?
I don't know.
It used to be smiles and sunshine. Now it's just littered with rain.
Sadness.
A depression. And bad decisions. Yeah. You can smell it in the air. The regret hangs heavy like a... like a child's frown after dropping his ice cream cone in a big pile of mud, and he won't get another ice cream cone because his dad only had a little bit of money, and that's all he could afford, and oh my God, I'm losing my mind.
Did they teach you metaphor in the army?
No, how did they do?
Oh, not very good.
What?
Ah, we're here. We're at the club. This makes sense. Oh no. We're at the club.
Sure.
I made a really stupid choice. I drove to the club instead of her house.
Well, if she's in trouble, then she won't be here. If everything's fine, she'll be on time for her set.
Right. I look up to you.
Sunshine can come from mud if it's hard enough. Hard, shiny mud can turn sunshine into stuff. Your rainy day can turn to sunny gleam. Just harden up yourself, harden up your world, harden up your life and harden up your dream. Sunshine and mud, sunshine and mud. Sunshine and mud. And now, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for enjoying the 2 hours of entertainment that I was able to provide. But she's finally here, the headliner of the show, Miss Evelyn Steamer.
Everything's fine. Oh, everything's fine and dandy.
I've never heard this song before.
She's shaking her head at us.
Everything's fine, so don't worry at all.
This isn't a song she normally sings.
No.
Oh, everything's great. There's no problem.
I think she's improvising.
Problems.
That's what seems like me.
Everything's fine. There's no problem at all.
What is she pointing at?
You should take a good look around and see if there is anything unusual to be found. You should look.
Great dance, great dance.
To see if there's some sort of connection. Oh, everything's fine.
I think I know what she's saying.
Do you?
Yes.
Everything's
here.
Fine.
Why don't you go get a pack of cigarettes? and invite Louis over to sit here. I want to talk to him.
All right. Good luck.
And see what can be found. Just look at me and you'll see everything is fine. Oh, it looks as though this is the part where anyone can buy me a drink. Oh, you, sir? Wonderful. I'll be back after a brief 2-minute break.
Relax, your subtlety wasn't lost on me. I didn't get this drink for you, I got it for Louis. That's right, Louis, isn't it?
Yes.
Why don't you get that makeup off and get your coat? I'm taking you out of here.
Oh, I've been waiting to hear a gentleman say that.
I'll see you in the back in 10 minutes.
I'll be ready in 7.
Pack of Pall Malls.
Tink.
Give up smoking, detective. It's bad for your health.
Oh, hey, Louie. I was just going to buy a pack to kill some time.
Kill some time? That's funny.
Probably shouldn't have used the word kill.
Yeah, to kill some time, it might be time to kill.
Look, Louie, you kill me, you kill cop. You know what they say.
Yeah, what do they say?
Well, they say a lot of things, but they say you shouldn't kill a cop.
Yeah, I've heard that.
Yeah.
I've never killed a cop before.
Well,
let alone a cop that used to be my friend.
Yeah, well, add it to your curriculum vitae.
Look, I don't want to do this, Bobby.
But you're going to do it, aren't you? Right here in the back of the coconut room.
Oh, that would be stupid.
You're going to take me out back?
That's for starters. That's a good idea. You know, you ever consider a life in crime? You might have a mind for it.
Oh, can I just get my pack of Pall Malls?
Go ahead. You'll need a last smoke.
To Denny. All the best, Louie.
Come on.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
All right, honey, where are you?
Right this way. Slowly, slowly. How could you do this, Carlotta? I thought we were friends.
Stand up here.
15 minutes.
Listen, don't look down. Look, I don't know why you have me on the loading dock on the back of the...
Don't worry about it. Now listen. Is there anything you want to tell me?
Sure, there's a whole lot of things I'd like to tell you, Carlotta.
Like what?
Is there anything I could tell you at this point that would stop you from doing what you're gonna do?
I don't know. Try me.
Well, look,
Like, what do you know?
I can make a deal. I know the district attorney.
Why would I need to make a deal? What have you got?
Can't we make some kind of a deal, Carlotta?
What sort of deal?
We got a letter. We got a letter from a certain ex-stepmother of yours.
Yeah?
I've still got
some cash from my time when I was with Mr. De Palma. I could make it worth your while to let me go.
What do you say?
What's in the letter?
Well, there's a lot of information about you. I could make it maybe go away.
I didn't want to hurt anyone. I did all of this for him.
For him?
Yes.
You make that information go away, then what kind of a cop are you, Bobby?
That's right. I'd never do it.
That one worked.
Now you listen to me. There's a detective coming around back here to meet me. And you and I are going to just stay calm, okay? Just stay real calm.
We gotta stay real calm.
Ladies and gentlemen, please just stay calm. Any noise you may have heard is just the drummer from the Late Show practicing backstage. Everything is perfectly all right.
I don't wanna stay calm.
Listen, Carlotta, he's not worth it.
I want him to love me.
I don't want to stay calm!
Carlotta! Carlotta!
Detective!
Carlotta! Baby! What happened? Baby, what happened?
I love you, Louis.
Carlotta, no.
I love you.
No, don't go. Carlotta, no.
He set me up.
Carlotta.
Gun.
Louis, don't pick that up, Louis. Don't pick that up. Louis, I want you to come with me downtown, and we're going to straighten this whole thing out, I'm sure.
We're going to straighten this whole thing out?
Sure.
Don't trust him.
There's so many kinks in this, it can't be straightened out.
I know it seems complicated, Louis, but it's simple. Like when we were kids, we would play stickball, you remember? I was the one always concerned with the rules, and you were the best one of all of us.
Because I didn't play by the rules.
Yeah, you found your own rules, that's for sure.
Come on, Smitty. You can let me go. Life, well, that's the only thing that matters now.
Louis, I got no reason to keep you. But the thing is, I found something that you gave a certain friend of yours. It's engraved. Denny.
That idiot.
Yeah, that idiot, just following orders, am I right? How could you, Louis? You brought all of this.
Look, Smitty, I done bad things. I know it, I'll admit it. I'm not a good guy, but who is? Who in this world is a good guy? You know any good guys?
No, no, I don't.
Where do the good guys end up? Them's that are good guys, they don't last very long, do they?
No, the best ones stayed on that side of the pond.
You're a good guy.
Look, I got two, huh? Look, I got two of them, and I don't want to use them. Why don't you give me yours, and I'll take all three of them downtown.
Smitty, there's no reason for me to go on. What am I going to do, spend my life in a lockup and stir? You're going to put me in San Quentin or Alcatraz?
No, I won't.
Is that where I'm going to end up? I'm not going to live there.
No, no, you always told me life is tough. Life is like a washboard. Isn't that what you always used to say?
Yeah, life is like a washboard. You want to get clean, you got to rip your knuckles up. And yeah. Nothing gets clean. No matter how hard you scrub, some stains don't come out. Some stains don't come out, and some ropes can only be unkinked when you're swinging from them. Smitty. You're gonna have to do your job, or you're gonna have to die trying. You're a good guy, Smitty. You might not be the best man in the world, but you're a good guy. If it had to be somebody to take me out.
Don't make me, huh, Louis?
I'm glad it's you, Smitty!
No! Ow!
Alana, I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry, baby. Oh, God. I'll never get clean.
He neck shot me. At least he didn't get my face.
Come on, will you follow me? Look, we gotta take care of you. Here, this way, huh? This town was so beautiful. And now these little dirt ruts are running with wine, running with blood.
Yeah, it's running a lot with blood.
All right, let's go. Yeah. Okay, after you.
Well, there you go, Miss Steamer. It's the new automated clothes washer. Brand new, brand spanking new. So if you need anything, Yeah, just call the Sears department and I'll be out to take a look at it.
So I just put the clothes in.
Yeah.
And they wash themselves.
They wash themselves. And then you just hang them up on the line. You and your husband are going to be very happy with the new Mega Wash 8000.
Mega Wash 8000.
What's it like being married to a hero? A cop like that? Boy, I've read about him in the funny papers.
Bet you read about him in the serious papers, too.
Yeah, yeah. I don't read those as much, though.
I'll tell you what it's like being married to a hero. It makes you feel real special. Huh. It makes you feel like a hero yourself. When you can get up in the morning and look at yourself in the mirror and think, I'm proud of who I am. I'm proud of who I married. And you don't have to hide anymore.
Huh. Well,
and now I only sing to my baby. I don't have to sing at the Coconut Club.
Oh, I got all your records, though.
Oh.
And I saw you dancing to your own record when I was coming
oh,
up the
well,
driveway.
I do love to dance to my own records.
Yeah, yeah. Well, anyway, let us know if you need anything. Here's our card.
Thanks, Skipper.
Hey, honey. How'd you like that gift?
Love it.
Why don't you do something for me?
What's that?
Sing my favorite song.
Which one's that, honey?
Napa Valley Red.
Napa Valley Red. Sure. For some reason, I always thought this was a duet. Why don't you come sing with me, honey?
It's all right, I know my part. But you start.
There's all kind of colors in the world you can see. All kinds of colors, it's a rainbow family. But there's only one that makes me go out of my head. Sweet Napa Valley Red.
There's a time to share with your love. A picnic in a park or dining above. On a terrace overlooking hills. That's what I said. Growing grapes for Napa Valley Red.
Well, they got their blends. They got their whites.
They got the warmth to keep you cuddled at night.
Chardonnay. Amber.
Sauvignon
Blanc. They got it in Napa. You don't have to travel to France.
No, with you and all we've been through. To come to the end of an evening, the only thing I want to do is pour a glass.
Pour a glass.
Cheers high.
Cheers high.
To love. To love,
to love.
From our toes up
to our head. Let us cheers with
Napa
Valley.
Thank you.